Welcome back to Get Set Builds. I'm in my pirate costume today. You know, an interesting thing about working with logic gates is that there's often more than one way to accomplish the same task. This servo has a target angle of 90 degrees, so it can be controlled using a simple button press. This servo has its 90 degree data stored in a variable, which is then multiplied by the signal of 1 coming from our button. This servo bypasses the need for a gate to store the data of 90 degrees separately by having the 90 degrees stored within the multiplication gate. This servo uses a blend gate, which stores both 90 degrees and 0, which we can toggle between by using a button. These servos show 4 equally valid methods of accomplishing the same task. I have noticed that the blend gate is very popular, not only because it's able to store 2 positions, but also because it can be turned into a simple memory gate like this one, which takes a number being input and stores it during a button press. However, what we've essentially done here is manually build a variable. Variables store data such as numeric values, which can be manually input into the variable. We can also update variables by using the increment or set variable gates. This makes it very easy to toggle between far more than just 2 positions with a single button press. Using only 2 buttons, we can easily pick which position we want this servo to point. And even though remote controls are not unique to variables, variables make it very easy to do this using only a single cable. In fact, this is so easy to wire that we can take our existing bearing controller and using a single wire, move it over to control this slider. So how do we use variable gates? First, you're going to need a variable gate to store your variable. In this case, we're using 2 increment gates set to +1 and -1 using our applicator tool. Next, connect an activator, such as this button, to each of our increment gates. Now, connect the variable's reference to each of the references on our increment gates. Finally, we're going to connect our variable to our slider to target position. Now, we can increment the value of our slider using our buttons. Note that this design could exceed the value of the range of our slider. We could fix this, however, it's not necessary for basic functionality. These basics should get you started with variables. We'll be looking at more advanced techniques in future episodes. See you next time on Get Set Builds.